After a long time without proper health facilities, the government thought it wise to put up one at Puhuhira sub-county and also equip other existing ones at Wesumbo sub-county and Kabatunda Kirabaho Town Council. They now have adequate equipment to serve patients, mainly the expectant mothers who used to travel 20 kilometers to access health services in the lowlands. The facilities were launched yesterday.
And you can see value for money for more than my country.
Wow! We are here to commission a health center 3 with all the equipments required to handle the expectant mothers to deliver this spray, to ensure that people come for OPD or outpatient department, and those would be admitted in the total ward and other places that have been put there.
And the total cost is about 800 million, 130, which is government donation of the night. And I think people are very happy and excited as well. They had no, the facility they had nearby was retained.
Lieutenant Joe Walusimbi, the Kasese Resident District Commissioner, urged health workers to remain committed to serving the people as the government continues to put up more facilities.
The facility is new, and they can see the excitement of the community, which have received the way they have welcomed the facility, which means they have owned it. So my humble request to the health workers to serve their expectations, because they have been, it seems they have been lacking something, but now drugs are there, everything is there, and they are even posted more staff to enforce the facility.
Speaking to some of the in-charges of the facilities, they were optimistic that the facilities will give relief to the people, no matter a few challenges that need to be addressed, especially the need for an ambulance.
It is now an integrated health service delivery. It is both OPD and inpatient. Lab services are all there, and the human resources are all there. So we are here targeting, aiming at reducing mortality rate in the sub-county of Wesumbu and fighting teenager pregnancy under the school-going girls.
Now we don't have ambulance services. It is totally down, and it's a very big problem. We are going to register maternal and neonatal death very soon. And actually we have started registering those complications. Referral is now a problem.
In Ibanda, several farmers from Chigarama Ward of Shesha Division in Ibanda Municipality are counting losses after strong winds destroyed their plantations.
Big wind, without any rains, came up and destroyed our food crops, especially bananas. The houses were not destroyed, but the bananas were totally destroyed.
Most of the affected farmers were doing commercial farming and are nervous about where the money for school fees will come from.
We are suffering now ourselves. So if you get some help from a government, we shall indeed support. We are all NRM supporters. And we are for sure we shall vote again for NRM. And shall vote for our leaders, those who are serving us.
Bananas and coffee plantations are all down. My advice to farmers is that they should plant windbreakers in their plantations. Wetland encroachers also need to change their ways. They are causing climate change issues. We experienced rains with strong winds that put down everything you see. Some of us had just paid school fees. Finding money to cater for the day-to-day running of our households is going to be a huge challenge. Report compiled by Samuel Amanyire and Timothy Mushabe for the news.